Now, when I was attending culinary school at the Culinary Institute of America, down in Hyde Park, I needed to make extra money. Obviously, I'm attending school. I didn't have much money to my name anyway, and I was financing my entire education. So I needed to make some extra money. So, as a lot of college students do, or let's say a lot of less fortunate college students do, we look for a job while we're studying. When you go into culinary school, I'm telling you, it's not as demanding as, let's say, getting your degree in becoming a doctor, or getting your doctorate. So you have no excuse not to work while you're getting your culinary degree if you have decided to get your culinary degree. But that aside, I had decided to get some extra work on the weekends, getting some money while I was going to culinary school at the CIA. So I found a restaurant in upstate New York that was looking for, sort of like an on-call catering help. And I looked up to this person quite a bit. I don't want to mention him here on this podcast yet until we speak a little more. But what I wanted to know from him, you see, this person that I worked for, he was a restaurant owner. But he did a ton of off-premise catering. And what he told me about the off-premise catering business, I never forgot. What he had said is that if it wasn't for the off-site catering business, his restaurant wouldn't survive. Now, if you think about that for a minute, you have a gentleman who owns a restaurant. He went to the same culinary school that I was attending at the time. And I was working for him part-time for cash. He told me that if it wasn't for his side catering job, or the catering that he does on the side, that he wouldn't be in business. And that's something to think about. When you own a restaurant, and when you get into the numbers side of owning a restaurant, you quickly realize how thin the profit margins are. And I know it's like really fucking cliche to say, profit margins of a restaurant are razor thin. Well, how razor thin really are they? They're between 10 and 14%, industry average, the best being 14%. 14% is what we call EBITDA, or earner's discretionary income before taxation. So 14% at best of all the sales that's made in the restaurant is profit before taxation and also what the owner has access to. So it's a very thin line of profit margin when it comes to a la carte business in a restaurant. So when it comes to a catering operation, it's a bit different because you know how much you're getting, you know how many guests you're getting, you know how much food you're going to purchase, you know how much food you're going to make, you know what the price is per person for this type of event, and you know what you're going to pay for labor. So him having me there on the weekends as a culinary student, and he's paying me cash like $200-$300 a weekend to come out and execute an event for him, he's making a lot of money. And so that leads me into the topic of this conversation, is how to start a home-based catering business. So why would you even want to start a home-based catering business? Well, first and foremost, the most important thing is money. Catering is the best way for you to make money in the hospitality industry. Catering, you don't have to guess, how many reservations you're going to have for the night. And catering, you write your own menus, you work directly with the customer, and you give them the perfect experience for themselves. In catering, you know exactly how much to order, how much to prepare, and you give yourself a bit of a margin of error. And that's about the only unknown that comes up in the catering operation, except for, you can't stop the acts of God if it rains in the middle of the event. You have to figure out how to execute the event. But starting a catering business, you get access to a whole lot more wealth really quickly, other than getting into the restaurant industry, which is extremely financially dangerous and on a personal life and a personal quality of life standpoint, it's going to do detriments to anything that you have going on in your personal life. You can forget about your relationships, you can forget about your family, unless they're going to be working in the restaurant with you. You can forget about that completely, and you're not even going to reap the benefits of owning the restaurant because the profit margins are so small. But when you when you mix in catering into that, you start making some real money. So why would you want to start a home-based catering business? Well, first of all, you have the experience to cook great food. The second of all is that you want to make a lot of money, and you want to make it quickly. You want to get paid for what you know. So starting a home-based catering business is extremely easy to do, and it's incredibly low barrier to entry as long as you have the skill to actually execute the event with high culinary skill and high safety and sanitation skill. So when it comes to starting a home-based catering business, I don't want you to think of home-based as something that you're going to execute everything out of your home kitchen. Rarely would that be the case, but it is a possibility. It's an option here for you to start your business. But when you start a home-based catering business, what I really mean is that you can start a catering business with no upfront costs. Let's say that again. You can start a catering business, home-based, with little to no upfront costs. I shouldn't say no upfront costs. So it depends on how official you want to make it. You want to get your food service license. You want to get a real business name. And those cost a couple $100s, and they're not hard to get, so don't go crazy about it. Don't get crazy about, you want to start a catering business, but you're too afraid to do it because, oh, I need to apply for this license and that license, and I need to get a business name and an LLC and all this. Just stop. First of all, you don't need to get a business name and an LLC. If you're starting on your own and you're doing your own business, you can work under yourself as a sole proprietor, and you don't have to register as such. But you could if you want to feel more official. You don't need a website. You don't need any of this. And you also can find ways to execute catering events and professionally equipped kitchens. There's ways to do it. There's a network within your community which you can access. And I teach you how to do that in my course. You can find a link to the free training to start this process in the description below, but you can find out how to execute these events in professional kitchens that you don't have to purchase in the course. Now, when I say no money down, I really mean no money down. When you start prospecting for clients and you start talking to clients and potential clients about their catering event, and you actually nail down what they're looking for, they're catering their grandmother's 50th birthday, there's going to be 75 people, this is the type of food they want, you actually develop a menu for them to choose from, and then they choose from the menu and you set up a banquet event order proposal to send to them, and you have it priced as such that you're going to make a profit, and you know exactly how much profit you're going to make. And if you don't know how to do that, I'll tell you in just a second. You know exactly how much profit you're going to make. If they want to work with you and have them cater your event, you require a deposit from this potential client. That deposit covers everything you need to get this event executed. Not to give you profit, because the profit will come at the final payment at the end of the event, but the deposit will cover all the expenses that you may incur, or a majority of the expenses that you may incur to execute this event, the 75-person birthday party or whatever it may be. So when I say starting a home-based catering business and why you should do it is because you can start this business with little to no upfront capital, because the capital that you need to purchase the product, to get the equipment, to find the commercial kitchen where you can pair the food out of, all comes from the client's initial deposit on the event. And the deposit can range from anything you want. You can say 30% of the cost of the event. You can tell them you need this $300 up front. Or you could say 50% of the cost of the event. In order to schedule your time and no one else's time for this certain day, I require a deposit of 50% or whatever you decide it to be to cover the expenses. So you can use that money to purchase everything that you need to make this event absolutely fantastic for the guests that you just nailed in. Now, when it comes to costing out an event, I've made this extremely valuable tool for you to use when it comes to costing an event and pricing an event for profit. There's a lot of chefs out there that really miss the ball when it comes to pricing, and they miss the math portion of it when it comes to pricing an event. They have the culinary part down, but they miss the pricing. And this is why I give for you for free my menu costing spreadsheet. It makes it so simple for you to take all the ingredients of what you're going to prepare for this catering event, and it breaks it down for you mathematically so you can know exactly what you're going to walk away from the event from, and you're going to know exactly what to tell the guests they're going to be paying per person, and so on and so forth. And you get that for free. I give that to free to all of my listeners. You just click the link below, sign up for the free web training, and in your inbox, I'll send you the free menu costing guide. And again, this concludes my podcast today about how to start a home-based catering business. If you want to learn more of my five-step process to starting your own catering business, click the link in the description. You sign up for the free training. It's 100% free, and I'll teach you the five steps that it takes to start your own home-based catering business and get you your first high-paying catering client, even if you're working a full-time job and even if you don't have any starting capital. I'll see you on the next podcast.